It won the World Car of the Year, World Car Design of the Year and the Green Car of the Year at the 2019 World Car Awards. It's a record that will unlikely be beaten anytime soon, and it now comes to India.
Now the IPS might be electric, but it's quintessentially a Jaguar car. So yes, of course, you have a very familiar bit, the overall design language. It comes from the CX75 concept, and there are some very likable bits like the single frame grille up front, the cat-eyed LED headlamps. The scoop in front, of course, is the highlight of the design here. Well, it's empty here, which means you get air passing through here. The side scoops here, which all make it an extremely aerodynamic car with a drag coefficient of just 0.29. But the very likable bit, and because it's an electric, is because there is no motor here. It's actually a frunk. Let me just show that to you. So at the pop of a button, you can access a very small space to keep your charger, the portable charger, and a little bit of knickknacks. Well, of course, because there is no engine here, you can use this space cleverly.
The IPS gets a distinctive coupe-like silhouette that complements the low bonnet. The squared-off rear design is a stark contrast to the cab-forward design at the front. And the roof spoiler adds to the aerodynamic quotient of the electric SUV. For the India spec model, Jaguar is offering the IPS with 19-inch alloy wheels across all three variants.
Now the great thing about the new age cars are of course that they are so tech friendly, and that is of course with the IPACE as well. So you get a digital console, you get the new PV Pro infotainment system. Now this unit is the same as the Defender in the JLR lineup. So you do get over the air updates, you get a lot of features, wireless CarPlay, Android Auto, all of that. Now you get a smaller screen over here. Now this isn't as big as other JLR cars or Jaguar cars in particular, but you get a smaller setup with twin dials for the AC controls, you get wireless charging, and you get your buttons in place for driving modes, for the air suspension to control the ride height. In terms of performance, this is very close to a supercar, even though it's an SUV, and the driver's seat really gives you that feeling. And on that note, let's talk about the performance numbers. Now the Jaguar I-PACE comes with two electric motors, one on each axle, and they make a combined power output of 394 brake horsepower and 696 Nm of peak torque. And that translates to 0 to 100 km/h in 4.8 seconds. At the same time, the battery is centrally mounted on the floor, and that makes a lower center of gravity and 50-50 weight distribution. It also gets all-wheel drive as standard across all variants, and that helps you put power down to the wheels quickly and more effectively.
And talking about the range, the I-PACE provides 470 km on a single charge from a 90 kWh battery pack. Now that of course is the ideal number, but in terms of true range or more realistic numbers, Jaguar says that you can achieve about 300 to 400 km on a single charge.
Now the Jaguar I-PACE comes to India as a CBU and is priced from 1 crore 5 lakh rupees onwards ex showroom India. Now of course at that price it competes with the Mercedes-Benz EQC. And that would be an interesting comparison to see definitely in the future. More importantly, we want to drive this in India and see how it reacts to our Indian conditions and how does it perform in Indian driving cycle. Do let us know what you think about electric cars and drop in your comments about the I-PACE right down there.